Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Call Flake Scribble. Welcome back to Rugby League Live number 3. It is episode 9, and we have 3 more cracking matches coming your way in today's episode. We kick things off in round 22. We're not suspended this time, so we get to go straight into our matches and kick things off at home against the 6th place Dragons. Let's have a look at the table while we're here to catch up. If you missed last episode, we have the Roosters still on top of the table. 18 wins, a draw, and a loss, both to the Warriors, I might add. 41 points, they have a 9-point buffer over the 2nd place Warriors. It's a tightly contested top 8, however, with the Eels and the Panthers just 2 adrift of the Warriors, and the Sharks are there 1 further back as well. So plenty could happen. Let's get stuck in. Game number 1 at home against the Dragons. It is pouring with rain here at Mount Smart Stadium. The Warriors at home, but we know from history in this competition this season that the Warriors aren't too fond of the rain, which could be a touch of a concern for the home team. Haven't performed their best in this kind of weather. They much prefer the dry. There is the starting 13 for the 2 teams. We are set to go. Clark with the ball on halfway. The Warriors will be kicking off in the black, of course. The Dragons in the white, ready to go. Kickoff underway by Clark. It is round 22 of the under 20s. So Warriors, 10 minutes in, they're on attack and they've got the ball just over the halfway line. Played out to the left, skipping out Abby and Clark going back. Flake puts in the nice cut. It's Clark and Flake. Even get their names mixed up. Flake plays dummy half. Oh, what a beautiful run straight through the middle of the defence. And pulled down just 10 metres short. Flake's there. Quick play the ball. He goes to the short side. Puts on Davin. Oh, he just about picks up. But Tom on the right defence puts it in goal. And it's a goal line dropout for the Dragons, who... the Warriors have yet to bounce, and simply it is who charges forward through 2 defenders. Repeat set now for the Warriors. Charging up, 2nd tackle set up through the forwards. Tackle 3, they look left, there's room, there's an overlap as well. It's 2-on-2, but they pull him down. Great defense from the Dragons early on. Flake goes short side to the corner. Oh, he's just in touch. How on earth do you figure this? Where's the ball? It's up all on the line. Tough call against Flake. That's fine. Last tackle for the Warriors. Chipped over the top. Not much of a real testing kick there by the Warriors. And the Dragons pull it back up. They look left side, and there's plenty of room out there. Atala slips it wide. Thompson going back towards centre field. Flake makes a good tackle. 0-0 nearing the half an hour mark. They go right to the wing. Tom! Already saved 1 try against Flake. Now he's looking to put the pressure on. Switching it. Thompson kicks over the top. Abby flirting with a touchline. What's he up to? Slipping in the rain, he's gone into touch, and a big mistake from Abby at the back. It's a scrum feed for the Dragons, and they'll look to the open side. Dufty looks to pierce his way through, but the scrum defense is good. Here's a chance for Kemp. Warriors shut him down on the 20. 2 tackles down. They come back to the right hand side. Great ball offload. A chance for the Dragons. Another pass. A chance from Lowry. And Blake Lowry is over. The Dragons hit the lead with a first scoring play. But how about these offloads? Brilliant. Lowry versus Sipley. And over he goes. Opening try. The Dragons strike first at Mount Smart. An extra 2 points on offer here. Could be 6 for the Dragons. steps up, a fairly simple one, should be no worries. And it isn't for Kloon. Last tackle for the Dragons. Kicked away from Kemp, great take from Flake. He's going to run it back. One off he goes. Two, he's in the touchline. Three, four, oh, he's away. What an exceptional run. Absolute destruction and mayhem left in the wake of Flake. He has destroyed the Dragons' defensive line with a phenomenal run from, where was it, his own 30? There's the kick, he caught it on the 30. Wow, what a run. Watch this replay and just watch in awe. Sure, the conditions helped this for Flake, but Bumfa didn't even give him the arm, the shoulder, charging away. And what a trail of absolute carnage behind the hooker. It's 6-4. Fairly quick reply to just after half time for the Warriors. Now Abby's pretty much right in front for this one. He needs it to tie things up. He does it. It's 6-6. Warriors forcing their way over halfway. Now they look for a little bit of a short side play on their second tackle. No room, nowhere to go there at all. Flake doesn't go the short side. Interesting call. There's a man charging up on the right touchline. Clark feeds it away. Oh, what a ball! Now it's a real chance again. Something through the middle. He stopped short. That is about 6 metres away from the try line. Could have been a game-breaking play for the Warriors. His Flake, he's held up. Reset on the fifth and last. Flake again, we have another go. He changes his mind, he goes back to Clark. And a real mess of a play for the final. Flake's making his way back on the field as Clark looks to play to his right-hand side of the field. The Warriors keeping some fancy handwork in here as they go through four passes and find it to ground on the 40. Here's Flake again trying to make an impact. That ball, oh, it's dropped down the back door. Picked up brilliantly, those Warriors make it all the way up to the 30. And they'll attack the Dragons line. There is just 6.5 to go. They're through again. Chance the Warriors. Just 9 metres short, down the penalty. Flake is off again, but Brad Abbey, handy position. Slot this, and surely the Warriors will win. There's a puddle right where he's standing. He has to be careful. Pressure to win it for the Warriors. Oh, he's put it wide. It is a miss. If there goes full time. One last stab for the Warriors. Flake, final tackle. Oh, that was close. But he goes to the ground on the 10. That is full time. The Warriors and the Dragons unable to be separated. 6-6 is the final score. We can see it there. Abbey with a chance that could have decided this matchup. Unsuccessful was the penalty attempt. That is a try for Flake. Conversion by Abbey. On the Dragons side, Lowry was the try scorer, and it was Kloon that took out the goal to make it 6. We're going to the stats and look at the time and possession. That's a massive stat for me. 89% to the Warriors. Where on earth did the Dragons 15 sets come from? I have no idea, but they got 15 out of 16. Good completion, a tight match between two very, very good sides. Going on to our objectives for that match, none at all. Well, we've got some experience coming in there. 2,000 for the performance, 300 for the result, a draw. Not really what they're looking for, the Warriors. Doesn't get us up another level. We're about two-thirds of the way to level 17. Might be something worth looking at in the next match if we get a good display in game number 2.
Panthers versus
The Warriors are on the road and they're away to Penrith, and the Panthers at home in this beautiful sunny conditions will suit the Warriors down to the ground after what we talked about in round 22. The wind and the rain not suiting the performance of the Warriors. Now the Panthers have actually leapfrogged the Dragons after the round 22 matchup where the Warriors and the Dragons drew. The Panthers moving up to fifth position. They're at home and they're up against the Warriors, who are sitting in second. Kickoff underway. Kick down. Flake takes it. He loves pulling back there. Gets rid of one. He's away already. Big chance for the Warriors. Slips out the back door. But the pickup is hotly contested. The Panthers shut it down. 30 metres out, back to Flake it goes. They're playing hot potato. What a ball as well. The Warriors are just 10 metres out. Flake's waiting. Goes left. Back towards traffic. A big chance. He's held up. So that'll be another shot at the play for the Warriors. 10 out. Short side for Flake. Gives it away to his winger, who has no idea where to go. Tracked. Puts it to ground. Flake. Charging, stepping, trying to get through about five men. Fifth and last. Just a metre out. Clark, little grubber through. Picked up brilliantly. May with a sensational play. Panthers looking to kick their way out. And the Warriors attack back. Flake gets a beautiful offload as well. How'd he pull that off? How's he not out? He's still in the field of play. Here's a real chance for the Warriors. Flake puts it away to his right. It's 0-0. 22 minutes gone. Another short side play for Flake. Looking, forcing his way through. Again, just hasn't got that last little play that we normally see from him. There's a nothing hit up there for the Warriors. Two tackles to go. Big one to Flake. Short ball. There it is. He's over. It's Price. Jack Price. Hits up his first try of the match, and the Warriors hit the board. The short ball from Flaker charging Jack Price, and in for the try, easily grounded, no problem. 4-0, Warriors over the Panthers. Always these kicks so important, and that one from Price was right in front of the stick. Should be no worries for Abby. And it's not. He's looked all right. The boot has to be set off the tee. Panthers, last tackle. They are just 15 out for the Warriors line. A good chance for a big bomb here. No, they out for the grubber. It's pulled up by Clark, and he's driven into his in goal. And it will be a goal line dropout for the Warriors. Here is Clark. He hammers this one downfield. Big kick going up towards halfway. Running it back is Luke. Flake puts him down quickly off the back of that play, and Flake's having all sorts of trouble keeping his feet there as he hits the deck a couple of times. Makes the third tackle as the Panthers look to their left side. They are just five short. Good hit from Flake, but the pass is away, and the chance, it's just half a meter out. Pop back. Hitting it up, straight to contact, no way through, it's a handover. Panthers on attack again. They've had plenty of opportunities to get this done. What a ball and what a take from Abby. Gets it back to Flake. He's charging upfield. Support on his outside. Slips it his way. But can't find the room. Good cover defense from the Panthers. They look to keep the momentum going. The Warriors. Abby's there. He wants to play dummy half. He feeds it to the usual, which is Flake, and he goes past one. Put down on the halfway NRL Holden Cup sign. The two wingers and centres. What a play! Up they go over the 30, and the Warriors on hot form. Flake strafing sideways. They're holding back. They're holding back, and they pay the ultimate price. Or do they? Or do they? Let's have a look. Oh, no worries whatsoever. How did that man get down so fast? Dreadful, dreadful stuff. Flake's got that all day and all night, Dan, for the next week as well. That's a try. Let's have a look. Yep, no question about that. What a play. In the Panthers' defence, you got to say, was horrible. Just holding back, tricking back, waiting for him to commit one way or the other. He didn't. He just kept going and took full toll. A really good opportunity for the Warriors. Their lead is now 10. Kick to come from Abby. Off the upright, that one. So Australia goes. Not a real hard effort either. Panthers inside room finding place here. Nicely done from Innes. Slipping in off the touchline. Did well. Penrith charging up. Crichton gets to the 30. Now they give it some width. In the middle of the park, May takes it to ground. Now they switch back to the left side. Room and numbers for the Panthers. Just 12 out from the Warriors line. Another chance here for Penrith. The bomb goes up. Here's the opportunity. Flake's under it. What on earth has happened there? I'm not sure, but the Warriors escaped from that one. Last tackle, Penrith, they thump it long, and Flake is waiting centre of the park, bumps off two, still going three, four! It's almost preschool stuff out there, counting to five, as Flake makes inroads. Big inroads as well, now the penalty to boot. This is impressive stuff from the Warriors, 10-0 they lead, a minute to go! Can they close this one out? With phenomenal style. They have the final set of the match. Half a minute left. Charging up is Flake. Again, side throw, he's in. That's another try. Flake is just too hard to stop. He is so elusive doing that sideways angle. If you're not going to commit on him, he will punish you. And the Panthers have been done twice in that same format of way. Time is ticking on as Abby lines up this conversion. There goes the whistle and the buzzer, whatever you want to call it. The siren's a better idea. Two out of three for Abby. He nails that one from the right-hand side, and that will be full-time. Warriors, a convincing big win over the Penrith Panthers. The final score, 16-0. And the away team getting a massive win here over the Panthers. Let's have a look at the stats. It is Flake, man of the match once again. I think every single game he has been so influential, but I think he deserves this one. Two tries, one also for Price. Abby, 2 from 3. You got to commend that. You look at the rest of the stats, the things you want to improve on and get good at. The completions, always key. 17 out of 19, I think most days you'll take that. Missed tackles and line breaks, all good for the Warriors. This time, a bit even in time of possession, but a great result for the Warriors travelling on the road to Penrith and getting the job done, too, against its side, who was threatening their position in the top two spots. Our objectives, not very good, failed them all again. We have, however, levelled up. Level 17 now. Again, objectives all incomplete. And we'll have some points at least to spend. 5 points should be coming to the bank of Flake. But some work needs to be done. We need to keep these levels ticking over. And we need to make our way up, get some more points, and become a real threat. Consistent threat, I think, is the thing we really want to put on here. I think watching our performances over the last few matches, speed, as always, is going to be massive. But I think fitness is the other one that we're kind of just on the limit for. A little bit more would go down quite nicely to last those full 80-minute games. Warriors versus the Cowboys. The Warriors are back at home, and look what's happening. It's pouring down with rain here at Mount Smart Stadium. Well, it's not much of a homecoming for the Warriors. Last time they were here, they threw away a chance to get a big win over the Dragons. Since then, they're away, destroying the Panthers. Now they're back home, and they've got the Cowboys, who are way down the ladder, 13th position. But as we've seen in recent rounds, the Warriors, They beat the Roosters, but they also lost to the Titans, who are way down there with the Cowboys. What will happen today? Let's find out. Kickoff is from the Warriors and deep into Cowboys half. Warriors on attack. On halfway, just no points scored yet. We are almost half an hour in. Flake. Oh, what a run from Flake. Fans, two men with one play. Couldn't get the offload away. There was a lot of men outside waiting for the pass. Just didn't come. Still hot on attack. Now the Warriors are stamping the drive. And the penalty. Well, that's very, very welcome for the Warriors. They're going to tap it. Thought they might have kicked for touch. They go. Flake. Big pounding hit. Just a few metres out. That looked dodgy forward, but he's charging upfield. Held up. This is a third tackle. Flake again. Stamps offload. Try. Oh, what a try. Clark is the benefactor. The offload game of Flake is alive and well. Back in Mount Smart. The crowd favourite. Look at this. Oh, was it forward? Woo, that's hard to call. The refs called a try regardless of what anyone thinks about that. And the Warriors are up 4-0 at home. The home fans love it in the pouring rain. Abby on the tee. And he's got it. Well, it's a welcome surprise. Fifth and last here for the Warriors. Oh! The Warriors have just kicked that into their own man, unbelievably. Trying to clear it on the last tackle, and they've just... What a dreadful play, and an opportunity now for the Cowboys. 30 metres out with almost a full set to go. Charging through the middle. Flake a bit lazy on defence here, they get up to the 20. Well, that is schoolboy errors from the Warriors. As the Cowboys continue to push on, 12 outs. Poor play there from the Cowboys. They go nowhere at all. Now they look to use some width. They've got room as well. That is the fifth tackle. Here's the last coming. High, high, up near the sticks it goes. Flake's one over the putback. The try. The try to stack. And the Cowboys are in. Watch this. This is masterclass stuff from the Cowboys. The putback here is splendid. The slapback, call it what you like. Well played, Cowboys. And Stack, the fullback, benefits fully with a response try as we just near halftime, a minute and a half to go. And we could be all tied up at the break. Here's the conversion. It's good. Done. Converts. It's the Cowboys on attack again. Charging forward. Oh, stolen from Sipley. He's been pushed back. Oh, what amazing defense. Attack has been turned from the Cowboys and they force a goal line dropout. Quite remarkable stuff. Sipley thought he had done all the hard work. It's again the Cowboys attack and Flake standing deep. Takes time to get the wheels rolling. Third tackle now for the Cowboys. They hit it up. They're 19 meters away. Could they take the lead here? Have they got room? Have they got time? Not on that play. Fourth tackle. The left side. There's some room and options here. But Abby comes in and covers up the hole. Last tackle. Option. Bomb. No, they go. Grubber. Stolen a thief from the night. Tutavaki has put it away. Watch this one. It's like a old man having his bread stolen at the supermarket. Flake was just waiting on that far too much. And the ninja skills of Tunavaki come straight through and steal the ball from his hands. Tri-time Cowboys, they take the lead. And you'd expect another two. Dunn makes no mistake of that. Last tackle here for the Warriors. Fired back and Clark punches this down the centre of the park. The chase is a nice flat line. Puts him down on the 20. It's Stack, the try scorer. Forward pass. Opportunity back for the Warriors, who will get the scrum feet. They are just 20 out. They look to go to the left side. Oh, big hit there. Oh, but the penalty. That's big. A big penalty call here for the Warriors. And they're going for two. Oh, this is an interesting call. So they trail by six. This could bring them a couple of points closer. I'm surprised they haven't gone for the try. And I'm surprised that he's nailed that, to be fair. Great kicking display from the fullback. 9 minutes remain. The Cowboys are on attack. The lead is just four. They go left, the Cowboys. They charge it up to Tunavaki, the one try scorer already. Options. They go, oh, there's so many numbers out here. It's Mitchell Dunn. And he has done it all himself. Flat pass. Oh, what horrible line defense from the Warriors. And that will sew this game up. Absolutely dreadful. You watch Flake's tracking on that try. He really didn't cover that hole that he was in. He left it gaping. You can see he's not happy as that kick from Dunn on his own try has gone way off the mark. Hasn't even crossed the try line. Fifth tackle kick from the Cowboys. Flake changes directions. He fends off the referee. He goes 45 metres up the field. Warriors with room again. 10 metre run up there. Good play on the left. Flake still going. Fending one. Out up just short of the 30. Trying everything here. They need to score next. But time is really against the home side here, 16-8 the scoreline. Flake, short side, he's got room, beats one, he's got the chance, two, he's away, 1-on-1, try! He's got it for the Warriors, and this one is not over yet. The way this Warriors team plays, anything could happen. He loves the touchline, it's his real friend out there. Infield he comes, big stack, no worries. Big charge into the one remaining defender. Had a man with him. Could have used him. Didn't need him. 12-16 is the scoreline. The home team trailed. Two very important points on offer here for the Warriors. Get this. And a try will win the game regardless. Oh, Brad Abbey. Take a bow, son. You have improved beyond belief. Last minutes to go here. The Warriors trail by two. They have just over 30 seconds to do it. Flake. Head up from the Warriors. He's going to have to do this himself, Flake, if he can do it. Final play. There's the Hooter. Slips in field. One. Passes back. Bad decision. He gets the ball back again. He's in trouble. He has to offload. It's 1-on-1 to fullback. The Warriors could have done it. But the tackle is taken. Why was it not a pass? 2-on-1, the Warriors could be and should be celebrating victory. They've let the Cowboys steal it. They were the best team coming home there in the last stretch, but they have fallen away to a 16-14 defeat to the 13th place North Queensland Cowboys. That will absolutely rip them to shreds. You look at the scoreboard here, and there's one big difference. 3 tries to 2. The goal kicking of Brad Abbey was sublime. 2 conversions and the penalty as well. Single-handedly got himself a converted try worth of points. But for the Cowboys, it was a try scoring. Tunavaki, Stack, and Dunn with one apiece. Dunn it was who got 2 conversions. The stats tell a full story as well. Completions by both sides, rather average. The Warriors, not the possession that they're used to either. Both sides making plenty of mistakes. And the line breaks weren't as high as we're used to seeing from the Warriors. It definitely gave the North Queensland Cowboys the opportunity to survive in this match. And they really did it from their 5th play kicks as well, which was their bread and butter go-to play. That got them pretty much all their tries, I think, apart from the gift that was given to Mitchell Dunn by Flake's shoddy defence. He was rather poor in today's matchup. So the final score, 16-14. Let's have a look at the objectives once again. Bad day at the office when it comes to these objectives. Making a good fist through that season one, though, but poor otherwise for the Warriors and Flake. So the experience ticks up. We're halfway to level 18. A couple of matches on, we may get that next level and push further on to secure some more stats and grab ourselves, hopefully, a good finish to the season. There's only a couple of games to go as well before it will be the playoffs. So the Warriors secure in their spot in the top eight. We'll have a look at the table in just a second. But the real thing is, where does the season go from here for Flake? Is he already thinking about a new move or maybe a new contract with the Warriors? You can see his contract is only for this year. Here is the table, however. I promise that we'll have a look at the Warriors' form in the last five matches. Not the best. Three wins, a draw, and of course the loss. The Sharks are right there. 2 points adrift, but they have a game in hand, as do the Panthers, the Tigers, the Dragons, the Raiders, and the Titans down the bottom there all have games in hand as well. So pretty much all of the top eight, bar three, have a game in hand over the Warriors. The Roosters at the top still, they are really cleaning it up. 26 points is eighth position. Should be no concern for the Warriors. I'll take it home. And that wraps me up here for today's episode number 9 of Rugby League Live 3 with Cornflake. Hope you've all enjoyed the episode. Thank you for the kind comments about this series as well. Hope to have more coming very, very soon. But until then, take care.